For those of you who have made it here live, welcome. Welcome. How many of you guys here are new? First time? Wow. There's a lot. Okay, okay, good. Welcome. Was for a year or more. Okay, okay. Webinar number 200. Yeah, our Mo works with us at Forex Watchers, so he's on webinar number 200 or plus probably. Steve Collin, new from the UK, been following for a while. Me from RSA. Okay, live from London, Nigeria, Malaysia, the sixth, Toronto. How often do you organize them? I do it every 2 weeks. Every 2 weeks, Chennai, Brazil, first. Hey, I don't even have to ask where you guys are from. It just keeps popping. You guys know these webinars. You guys watch all of them, I guess. Dubai, Afghanistan, Singapore, Texas, Portugal, Sri Lanka. Excellent, excellent. Bangkok. Oh, Bangkok. Great. We got our staff in Bangkok. Netherlands and Thailand. Oh, Armo. Pero, I love you too, man. Netherlands, Toronto, Detroit. Lithuania. Okay, good. All right, so let's get started here. Now, for those of you who are new, obviously you'll notice we do things a little bit differently here. We do a lot of stuff interactively. So I ask some questions, you guys answer. So this, whoever's watching this recording, you have to be patient. Because it can get like you're just waiting for someone to answer and this and that. So that's why you have to attend these things live if you can. There are shortened versions of the recordings on our website usually. But let's get started here. Let's get started here. You changed my trading life. Good, good. I'm good to hear that, Peril. I hope for the best, yeah? All right. Okay, so let's open up the charts. Yeah, I'm Fabio. I'm just getting it started. Give me 1 second here. Okay. Okay. Peter Sandler, is your base computer a Mac? Yeah. Yeah. Chris, password so strong, no one can use it. Yeah, it's so strong, even I can't use it. And that's the worst part. Okay. This webinar, I'm currently in Montreal. Sunny and windy outside. It's starting to get cold. We'll be in San Diego next week. So those of you in California, please do come catch up. We'll be there for 5 days. And then Japan next month. So those of you in Tokyo, I will be there. Should come to Vancouver. Yeah, we'll make a trip. We'll make a trip. Making another trip to Toronto probably this month. And then we'll see. All right, let's get started here. So today's topic is on support and resistance trading strategy. So how many of you guys have seen my support and resistance webinars from before? Yeah, one, two, some no's. Okay, so let's do a brief overview of support resistance and how I see support and resistance. And then last week you guys had a request on making sure the support, you guys want an entry and exit strategy. So we're going to go detailed into that today. Okay, let me see if I can make this larger. Maybe I can't. All right. In the course, oh yeah, have you guys done the fast track course at forexwatchers.com? Let's take a screenshot of this. Okay, so for those of you who have not done it twice, excellent. Yeah, for those of you who have not done it, I will get you guys a link out with the webinar recording, okay? So you guys will have it. All right, so I'm gonna draw a circle on my screen. Let me know if you guys can see it, and there it is now. Yeah, okay, fantastic. Okay, so support and resistance. The way we do support and resistance at Forex Watchers is basically we look for an area that has resistance at a certain point and it has been broken through quite strong. Now, a strong breakthrough means that level had some importance, that it needed that much pressure to get through. Okay? Does that make sense? So, if I extend this out to the right, it doesn't hold as support, but it does hold again as resistance. Okay? So, it's basically meaning a price point that keeps getting rejected again and again and again is a price point or a price number area where people are actually interested in. When I say people, I'm talking about larger players, because we can't move the market. So it's not us who's interested. So it's larger players interested in this area. Now, couple things. Now you may be wondering, okay, I get we can draw a line, but how do you know how to draw the line exactly? Right? Isn't that a common question for most people? Like, how do you draw support and resistance exactly? Okay, so we're gonna go into that right now. Now, when you look at price like this, we might be wondering, are we drawing a line like that? Are we drawing a line at the body here? Are we drawing the line at the tail there? Well, which one is it gonna be? Yeah, it's the entire area. It's the entire area. So you need to drop it from your mind that it's going to be one line, because it cannot be one line, because the prices on my charts are going to be different from the prices on your charts. So it's going to be this area, thereabouts, like that. Okay? Once you have that thereabouts area, you then work with the market as it approaches it, and then you make a decision accordingly. Okay? So let's get into all that stuff. So let me clean this up and let's take a look at something like this. So when you see something like this, how do you draw your support and resistance on something like this? Or something like this? Body and wick. Okay. Okay, you can do body and wick. Can do body and wick. Actually, is anyone here from Forex Watchers here? I know Armo, you're in here. Anyone else from Forex Watchers here? No members. Astrio, you're at Forex Watchers, I believe, right? Astrio Mira. All right, Astrio, do you know how we draw our support and resistance on these ones? Paresh Patel, draw two lines, one at the wick, one at the body. Yeah, that's the way I've taught it. There is one more piece of information though. Okay, where there are other points on the chart, two or more points. Okay. All right, so take a look here. This is how you draw on stuff like this. Now, were you guys here last webinar when we discussed candlesticks? What does this candlestick look like on a higher time frame? Here's the opening price, here's the closing price, and this is nothing but a wick. So it's like opening, closing, and this is nothing but a big wick. So if you consider that, it's like, isn't this right here resistance right there? And that's just a probe, or a fake out if you want to call it. It's just doesn't exist. Okay, hence, if you extend this out, there comes your support. Make sense? Same thing over here. Look at all this resistance. It pops out and pops right back in. You're gonna extend this out, and you got your resistance again. Okay? No, you can do this on any time frame. It doesn't have to be on the 1 hour time frame. All right, so let's keep going. All right, so when we're looking for support and resistance, here's a tricky question. Now, this is a common question that most people do not know yet, I would say. At least the ones I come across don't have the understanding of this. Now, when the markets are going up and then they turn back around and come down, what's the most important thing as they're coming down? Yeah, Perro, this is recorded. Break of support, retracement. Okay, so we're looking at support, right? We're looking for support. Munder, what time frame? I'm not sure what time frame this is on my chart right now, but it doesn't matter. It's 1 hour charts, but it shouldn't matter. Just we're just going through the understanding of support resistance. A chart's going to be the same on every time frame. Okay, so most people are generally watching this area here as support equals resistance here. But remember, this on the bottom is also counted as support. Previous support can also be support again. Okay, so when the market crosses through this, generally people think it's broken support. It actually hasn't, because there's this support here as well. So that needs to be very clear for everyone to know. Okay, does that make sense? Did everyone get that? Okay, let me draw it again. Let me draw it again real quick. Okay, when the markets are going down, the point of interest for everyone is this spot right here, right? That this support, once it breaks, it's a sell. But it's not a sell yet, because this is also considered a support here. The previous support can be a support again. It doesn't have to be resistance that turns into support. It can be support that's still a support also. Make sense? It's like this. Markets are coming down here, right? So he went through resistance. He came down, he broke support. Is that a sell? No. It's using the previous support again to bounce off and recontinue. Okay, so that's a good question. You'll have more support. How many does it have to break? Good. That's a good question. All right, so we're gonna get into all of that stuff now. So everyone got the core basis of support and resistance, yeah? We wanna use stuff from our left, bring it out to the right, and measure stuff from there. Okay, now we're gonna go into when, why, how, and all that stuff. Okay, let me get a different chart for you guys. Let's put in what, Euro USD? Okay, there we go. All right. How far do we have to go? That's a good question too. I'll answer that for you guys as well. Okay. Let's take a look at this now. Now, whenever you start something, you start it from left to right. Okay? It's like reading a book. You read from left to right. Okay, now I'm not saying read from left as in like 1960 left and then come down to the 2016. I mean left as in what you see on your screen, get the most information out of it as much as you can. Now, higher time frame always plays a role. Okay, you can get a very good understanding of the higher time frame or more information from the left just by switching to a higher time frame. Okay, all right, so let's take a look at this one here. So we got support equals resistance here. We got this area and we got this area. We got these zones here, right? Okay. So we can extend these out as much as you want. Blah, 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 blah. And voila. Okay. Now, we got this support equals resistance area up here, right? And we got support down here, resistance over here, support again here, some resistance here, resistance here, resistance here, support there. Okay, there's a bunch too messy to know, too messy to understand,
right? So the clue for everything that we need to do is understand how the turn happens, the shift happens to the other side. And once the shift happens to the other side, are we focusing on resistance or support? So let's take it in step by step, okay? So as the markets are coming down, we're gonna start from the left corner. Let me get rid of all this. Okay, we're gonna start from this corner. We're gonna work our way down, okay? So markets have collapsed down all the way until here. Yeah, everyone see my red line? Yeah, okay. So markets have come down all the way until here. They've broken through support equals resistance. They've come down, and now we're trying to see what happens in that area. Will it hold? Okay, so we wanna use this together with the speed of the market. Don't forget the speed it's coming down. Don't keep it very technical, like if it breaks support, then it's a sell. If it breaks resistance, it's a buy. Don't keep it too simple like that. Put more information into it. So look at the speed of the market. Is it fast or slow? Fast, okay? Okay, now, that's piece number one. What's piece number two? How far did it go fast? How far did it go? It went from here down to here, right? Okay, very far. Okay, that means this is equal to market is strong, okay? Or the sellers are very strong. Okay, sellers are very strong. So the chances of this continuing into sell, it is becomes a high percentage. Now, if you don't even show me the charts and you just tell me prices went from 3250 to 1187 in a matter of four candles, I will say the next wave is gonna be a sell as well. It's just more logical to say it's gonna be continuing into a sell. Okay, does that make sense? But it's not gonna be a sell forever. Now, here's the thing. I repeat this in every webinar, I'm gonna repeat it one more time. Okay? No one sells from here. Everyone starts to sell here. Okay? Because people participate, they don't anticipate. Does that make sense? People turn on their monitors and they see something moving and then they jump in afterwards. Okay? They don't anticipate a move. And that's the main problem of trading or gambling or anything. It's a common issue for everyone. Okay? So it's a psychological issue. So people jump in after the move is starting to happen. So once they jump in afterwards, you're gonna expect a retrace because they need to lose their money first. While the retrace is happening, we're keeping a close eye on where is it gonna retrace to. Make sense? So retrace to where, and we wait, okay? We're the anticipators. We're gonna wait and we're gonna see where it's coming to, and the retracement has to come somewhere near SNR. If it doesn't come near SNR and it leaves without you, it's okay. Wait for the next one. Let it come towards your SNR. You have a higher chance or higher probability of using your sell again if the SNR is there to support you. Yeah, so far so good. Everyone with me so far? Anyone confused? And Bilal, there is a connection of supply and demand, support, resistance. We'll get into that probably towards the end of the webinar if I get some time. They're not much different. How to find how much it will retrace? Okay, that's a very good question. Sorry, not very good. That's a very good question. Okay. Just like I asked you these two points on how it came down, I want you to understand these two points, how it's retracing. How's it retracing? Let me clean it up, okay? Let me remove everything. Let's see how fast that removes everything. Okay. Yeah, not much buyers, right? Look at how many candles it goes up and stuff like that. Tons and tons of candles. Look at all those candles. First red bar is very strong, so enter opening of next bar. No, we'll get into the entries in a little bit. First, I need you guys to understand the logic of the movement. Once you guys understand the logic of the movement, then we can start to understand when is it time to look for entries and exits. Okay? All right. So far, so good. All right, next wave. Okay. It then proceeds down again, breaks this support here. How does it break it? Point number one. Strong or weak? How does it go down? Ah. So here's the thing. Now we got multiple answers. We got medium, weak, and strong. Chan, that's the right answer. Anath Prasad, that's also correct. It's weaker than before or not strong like before. That's very good. Okay, so it looks very strong, but if you compare it to your previous wave, it's not very strong. What does that tell you? What's that tell you about the overall sellers? Yeah, they're weakening, they're dying, or they're getting scared. They're afraid of the buyers. Yeah. Okay, so this is a very key information. So it is strong, but in the context of dying. Okay? So you can't forget that. Okay. Next thing. How far did it go? Not far, yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna put NF, not far. These are not set fixed letters. I'm just writing them for you guys to see. Yeah, 1/3 of before, which means he's gone down even less. Okay, now remember the candlesticks webinars. How if this is support, if that's support, and he's gone down strong but not very far. What if he comes right back inside? Doesn't that mean that's just a tail on the higher time frame? That low never happened? So you have to be very careful of that if this is strong. So there's one thing to remember. If this thing goes down strong but not very far, watch out for a fake, for a faker. Okay? This is why you never participate. You'll end up selling right there. You always anticipate. You sell when there's a buy and you buy when there's a sell. Right? Would you want to buy it when the price is on a discount, or do you want to buy it when the price is getting expensive piece by piece? Okay, so always remember that. You know, it's like grocery shopping. All right. So, moving on. So, how does this one retrace now? What's the retracement of this? No, but this is not a, Adrian, this is not a fake. It never came back in and stayed inside. Yeah, this is the rubber band man theory. If you guys seen one of my really old webinars about the rubber band man. Okay. It's come back to support resistance. Okay, these two things. How did it come back? Strong or weak? Strong. Yeah, it these are big green candles. It came back at full speed. In three candles, he took back 70% of what it did in five candles on the way down. Or six candles. It took it all back in three. Do you see how I'm comparing the logics? Okay, and then the retracement was also deep, right? Okay, so now put that information together. So it dropped less than last time. It retraced more than last time. What's that telling you about the overall flow? Buyers are taking over. Good. Okay. Now, the one thing I want you guys to take at least away from this webinar is that's the moment when you say stop. This is red alert moment. You do not trade at this moment. Otherwise, what you're going to do is you're going to sell here. You know, this is the 1 hour chart, but imagine the 4 hour chart. How does this look like? It looks like a big sell from here to here, and then everyone participates down here. Everyone's selling down here. Exactly. It'll be very, very late. So that's the moment your red light should go on. You say stop, wait for the market to turn or refresh itself. Market needs to refresh to continue, which means it goes into a range, and then it can continue down south, or it's turning the market around completely. We'll get into that. Okay, so far so good? Yeah, Chan, we'll get to the third one, wait. But so far so good? So right around this point, let me put the arrow. Right around this point, you're getting the feeling of watch out. Yeah? Okay. Now, the next move happens. He happens to go stronger and actually ends up going lower. He breaks through the support equals resistance and he gets lower till here. Okay. Now, compared to the previous one, what is this one now? Yeah, it's a stronger sell move, but it's slower. Look at the amount of candles it's taken to get from here to here. It looks like it's bigger than this, right? And it is. It's traveled a further distance, but in a lot more time. This traveled here in 6 candles. This traveled a little bit further, but in like 20 candles. You see the difference? That means there's buyers pressuring. And every step of the way, they're pushing as hard as they can. It's almost like, come on, give me any last price you can give me. This is very important to know that. Because most people will just look at this as it's broken support equals resistance, let's keep selling. Make sense? Well, Deepak, that's what we're discussing, right? This is how we know the trend is over. Yeah, Peter, you can also use colors as well to get an understanding. Okay, so the next thing here, let's take a look here, is at this stage, we have the final moments of a sell. Now, this is how you're gonna find out if your sells are over. So the markets are going down, pullback. How much pullback? Quickly, in percentage, what's the pullback? 23, good. Markets go down more, what's the pullback? 60, 50, good. Markets go down more, what's the pullback? 30, good. Markets go down not more, and what's the pullback? 100. Now is the moment you start thinking differently. Because now you're like, okay, so we've transitioned from a downtrend, we've slowed down like crazy, and we've transitioned into a sideways movement. A market never goes down and then up. He needs to transit. He needs to go and pass through. Okay? So he's gone down, transited into a range, and now you're like, why into a range? Range means equal buyers and equal sellers are fighting now. This means this is a price that is important to buyers. They don't want to let go of this price. It's a discount for them. They want to buy this. So you can go to a higher time frame and research, what the hell is this area? Why is the market stopping here? To get a better understanding of more pressure. But if you simply do not do that and you just look at one chart, all you will know is the transition is happening. Okay? So we stop trading, the transition's happening, and now your job is to find out, how can I anticipate the move to turn? Because that's gonna be the biggest move. If I try to buy here, how much profit am I gonna make? In fact, I might lose money if I jump in later. But if I'm buying during the sell market, I have a better chance of making money, which is three times as much as my risk. Or if I lose money, I lose one time my risk. Does that make sense? So then you're just using the market to play a risk reward game. Okay, DW, we didn't do any selling strategy on the sell. I was just going through how the sell is transitioning, so you know when to stop the looking for entries and exits. Okay, we should realize there's a new support formed in the sideways movement. Yeah. So when do you enter? When do you enter early to profit from the move? Okay, so we're gonna get into the buy section now, and then we'll do a sell example too. I'm not gonna end the webinar in 5 minutes. We're gonna take it all the way up to the hour. Yeah. So if you guys still wanna be here around, I'll take it for another 15 minutes. All right, here we go. All right, let's clean all this. Okay. All right, how do we know it's going up here? Omer, we don't know it's going up, but we have a high understanding that it's probably trying to do something different. It's trying to transit. So the main goal is to attempt buying from the bottom of support and take it up to here maximum for profit, but with the ability to say, I can try to hold it and I will move my stop loss to zero to see, will the market turn? If it doesn't turn, I will take whatever I can here or here or here if it comes back at me. Okay. Is it possible after a selling market and in a downturn movement and Is it possible after a selling market and in a down movement it goes down again? Of course. When it turns up into a range, the market can refresh and then proceed down. So if it does that and proceeds down on a higher time frame, okay, I want you guys to just visualize right now. The markets are going down, then it turns into a range, and then it goes down further. What do you think this looks like on a higher time frame? The markets went down in one candle, it went sideways one, two candles, and then it went down again. What does that tell you about the sellers? Yeah, the sellers are strong. So if you have this range a little bit higher, we have a better understanding that, okay, markets are gonna turn. But if you have the range this low and just holding like that, you have to be careful of the higher time frame, because this could also mean the sellers are preparing for a massive sell. That's why if you buy from here, it's around this spot. You want to be very curious at this area right here to see if that's going to react and drag the whole market down, or if it can break through and change directions. This is the area what we at Forex Watchers call the money spot. When the transition happens and then we get to a point where it can choose A or B, it becomes the money spot. And how good you read it from higher time frame to this time frame makes you a better trader, which increases your odds in your favor. So the money spot gives you a higher chance of earning that money. Make sense? Yeah, you can't always just win. It doesn't work, right? So if you can't always just win and you let that information sink in and you agree and accept it, then you're gonna trade mathematically. You're gonna work on everything that you do must have a chance. Yeah, you can sell or buy from the money spot. Now, Gabrielle, if you are selling, you will sell from top of the range. If you are buying, you're gonna buy from the bottom of the range.
Deepak, absolutely necessary to put stop loss. Inobong, no problem, no problem. It's recorded, so you can watch it again. DW on sideways, how do you know if it will move up or down? Okay, that's a good question. On a sideways market, how will you know it's going to move up or down? I want everyone to stop now and just think for a moment. In a sideways market, how do you think the market is going to go up or down? There's one quick answer, is to wait for Naveen to give me the answer. But I want you guys to do more. I want you guys to think for yourself. I'm trying to make you guys traders, right? Is the sound gone? Is there no sound? Okay. Yeah. So I want you guys to think for yourselves and just take a moment without thinking about the charts and be like, if it's a range, how will I know if the market wants to continue down or not? How would you know? Okay, Adrian, so let's start with one answer at a time. If it breaks support, okay, it's a sell now, but then I sell at that time and I'm too late. So I can't do that. I need to know ahead of time. Okay, break out the range, Deepak, also means I'm selling very late. Once it breaks out, then I'm selling after a move has happened. That's too dangerous. Okay, size of the candles. Okay, DW, very good. Once it breaks through a certain level, that's Omera. That's a good try, but also means we'll be very late to trading. A huge candle every either way. Okay, Munder, that's close. Pin bars on top of the channel. Peter, excellent. Exhaustion candle, lower time frame for a failure, also correct, etc. Wait for exhaustion candle as an indication for the market is changing. Yeah. So two things. One of the things we like to do is watch for a fake out. Because just like most of you guys said, wait for it to break on the side of on one side. For us, that means, okay, wait for it. It comes back. Okay, sell it. So that's when we get excited, but not at the moment it breaks out. Okay? Because at the breakout is when everyone hops in, because they've been waiting too long. They got bored. They want to do something. So once it breaks out, they all jump on it. Okay? So you also have to understand psychologically, no one is doing anything here. They're bored. They want to do something. Does that make sense? So that's one of the ways. Next way I'm going to show you here. Let me open this up. Even JP Morgan. Well, JP Morgan has his own way of doing things. I'm going to go up a time frame. I'm going to go up to the 4 hours. Yeah. This is September 1st. Okay. Where is September 1st? Do. September 1st. Perfect. Okay. Okay, here we are. So September 1st was this area here where we had the range. Okay, now looking at this chart, which direction would you say the markets are going? Yeah. So now do you get a slight hint of like, there's a higher chance it's gonna do this. Now, here's another thing. You ready? Okay, everyone stop typing for a moment. I'm gonna show you guys something very important. All right, take a look very carefully here. Just like I showed you guys in the 1 hour, how things were coming down and retracing a lot, coming down more, retracing even more to 100%. Then we said, aha, it's time. Now we're on the 4 hours. It's coming down, retracing, 100% retracement. Aha. Look how it comes down after that. Struggle. And look at this movement after that. It just takes off like a rocket. So you can also anticipate large moves as well. Make sense?
So when the big selling here happens, you can know that big sell is a faker. Okay, let me try to explain that again. I know it's a bit confusing. Let's do it again in a different language, in a different way. All right. Now, the sellers were coming in, right? We saw it even on the 1 hour. Okay, here's the sells coming in. Boom, retraces, boom, retraces, boom. And then it retraces all the way up to here, which is a previous support equals resistance area. Very, very high. Okay, you can call this 100%, or you can call this, if you're using this area, 150% or 200%. Okay, but you start to see massive green candles, which means buyers are here. Okay, once buyers are here, they clear out this resistance. They touch him, go through him, come back down for a retrace, but now he's free. There is no upper limit for us. It's open grounds. Because there's nothing there. Okay? And our range has a support right here. And this one down here. So, market comes down, reacts. Market comes down, comes back in, and then it takes off. These are what we call the tests phase, the test phase. Once we know the buyers are here, we need to see if are the buyers really here. Show me a struggling seller. The test phase is the last time the sellers make their attempt. They try for any last price they can get. Same thing here. You see here, like Peter saying, look here, look at the sell here. Buyers take over, sellers last attempt as the test phase before the takeoff. Okay, here, buyers kick in, not so clean though, it doesn't look like it's almost 100%, but then look at the sellers, they struggle, and then take off. That's how you see a turnaround in the market. I'm not sure which MAs these are. I just have them plotted there. It's a visual thing, Siraj. Things like 512 or 821 or something like that. These are EMAs. It's just for visual understanding which direction the markets are heading. Michael, I'll forward you an email to him. Work with him. I don't know if he's going to be busy or not, but be nice to him. he's a good friend, and he'll help for sure. But see what he can do. All right, where should we put our stop loss in this area? Okay, so let's discuss that real quick. We got 6 more minutes. Let's discuss that. So in this chart, you're trading. Let's say you're trading the 4 hour time frame. You're not trading the 1 hour, and you see all of this happening. The market turns around. He goes from equal movements. And then he rolls all the way around, gets up to here. And then you're like, okay, here it comes, test number one. Okay. The buyers attempt. Here it comes, test number two. The sellers are getting weaker now. There's more candles coming down. Okay. You have to enter somewhere in this zone here. We'll have to do probably one more webinar on entries. Okay. You'll have to enter somewhere here. Generally, I like to put my stop losses below this guy. But if you are aggressive, you can put your stop losses just below this entry here. If you enter here, you can put it just below your recent low there. If you put it below your recent low there, you're working with a larger risk reward, which means if you're going from here all the way up to here, you're looking at a 4 or 5 to 1. Okay? Okay, 4 or 5 to 1. But when you're working from somewhere down here, you're looking at a 2 or 2.5 to 1. Okay, you'll make less money, but you're safer. Here you'll make more money, but every now and then it'll stop you out before it goes. It can do this spike before it goes, because a big move is coming. So they want to take out everybody before they go. You see this right here? Look at this, 100% retracement right there. Everyone see that? This side right here. Once that 100% retracement happens, here's a test, and if you buy that, look at that. that will stop you out before it goes. This is very common. So if you put it below your recent low here, you'll be okay. But if you put it below the recent low here, you have a chance that either you're going to make a lot of money or you will lose that one R, one risk to reward risk. So it's a choice that you make at that moment, how aggressive or conservative you are. Okay, Ambilan, let me one question. Since you asked, do you trade any high impact news or your opinion on what is called fundamental analysis? No, I don't trade high impact news because, you know, high impact news is a movement that you have to participate in. You either anticipate or you participate. It's always like that. Now, a news will generally do stuff like this. That's hard to play with. You know, wherever you sell, it's like you're going to get stopped out. And then it goes in the sell direction and you feel really angry. So you have to be careful with news. I'm not a big fan of the news. It's a good way to get everyone excited into the market and, you know, get their money on the table. Yeah, that's true. Adrian, the movement continues after the news. So we can look for pullback sells after that. Well, Michael, the way to predict is the way that we've been doing at Forex Watchers. We do it based on technical, and we do something called correlation. Correlation is our way of looking into the fundamental market. And I have a webinar on correlation on our website at forexwatchers.com. So if you watch that, you'll get an idea. Yeah, Omer, how about this? The next webinar, we'll discuss entries and exits. How about that? Okay. Actually, I don't know. Wait. Let me check. I think the next webinar, because my staff is choosing all the webinars. So let's see. I will put out a announcement next week on the webinars. Which webinar is coming up? For those of you who are not on our Facebook page also puts events on when the webinars will be. Or you can always get an email from us if you're on our signed up to our subscription on Forex Watchers. So. Ahmed, I the fast track course, I'll put it up there. We were renovating the site and the link is out, but here it is. If you guys want it, let me type it in here. forexwatchers.com/fast-track-course. I think that's the one right there. Sanjay, yes. I'm getting some feedback regarding the chat room. Some people are upset about that, but I'm seeing a lot more progress without the chat room. There's no more third-party nonsense that's coming in and saying, oh, look at my new strategy. Try this thing, try that thing. And all the information that they've been sharing in the chat rooms is just... It's confusing the members. I need the members to focus in one direction. You can't hop around too much. If you hop around too much, you're going to get all over the place and you'll never be consistent. Okay? Naveen, will you be doing any more of your 1 hour chart with pivots? Yeah, sure. We can add that to our list. All right, guys. So any last questions? Any last minute questions before we end the webinar? Do you encourage hedge trading? No. There are techniques for it, but I'm not familiar with them. But we don't go for hedge trading because it's a broker's money-making strategy. Yeah, it's okay to learn different strategies, DW, as long as you learn the strategies with an open mind. Like if you learn a strategy, for example, like I'm telling you support resistance, right? So if I teach you support resistance, like you have to sell when it hits resistance, that's not learning it with an open mind. That's closing your boundaries. But if I'm telling you how to, when to do it and when not to do it, then you're opening your mind to price action. You're understanding the logic rather than the strategy because the logic is more important. Okay, hopefully that makes sense. Bruce, excellent. I'm glad you like the Urban Towers and pro trading. Would you go, Gary? Would you go as far as to say that the market makers and has complete... The market makes and has to complete patterns. Yes, Gary. Patterns are a way for us to recognize the human behavior of the interactions in the market. That's why we recognize patterns. It's a human thing to do. Astrology, to prejudiceness, to racism. Humans just like to notice patterns. That's all they do. That's all we're known for. So the market also follows a pattern because we watch patterns. Okay. How would you analyze current market today? Jorge, we don't have much time yet for doing live analysis right now. Let's see. Does a technical analysis work in extreme volatile conditions? Adrian, yes. If you're aware of multiple time frames, yes. Do you think it will ever be a one currency? No. No, there will be multiple currencies. No one will give up power. Can you use Fibonacci to know how far the market will pull back before you enter a trade? Yes, you can. You can. I'm not a big fan of Fibonacci, but it works fantastically. It's just you just need to know exactly where to plot it. So it's a hit and miss every time. Can you have a one webinar on pit milking strategy? Sure, we can do that. Elliott Wave, what's your opinion? Ahmed Q, we like Elliott Wave. That's the wave of the 1, 2, 3 almost. We work very similar to it. So I've studied Elliott Wave with an open mind, if you want to put it that way. So I really like them. How do I get into your live webinars? You get an email just like you did today, and you can attend by clicking on the link and showing up on the date and the time. Market legs webinar, Ananta, we have that in the fast track course, the link that I put up. It's in there. Do you agree that the markets have become chaotic and less predictable this year? No, they were more chaotic. More chaotic means more money. I think Forex Watchers is probably doing better this year than they did last year. So we prefer movement. Movement is good. Yeah, Sanjay, I'll put in the a list for entry and exit for higher time frames. I'll put it in the list. Inobong, what I want you, yes, I do have a lot of strategies. What I want you to learn is the core. I don't want you to learn the strategies itself. If you look at all my strategies, they speak in a certain way. They make you look at the market differently. That's the main purpose. But the word strategy is what attracts people, so I have to put the word strategy out there and give a plus B is equal to C method. But I don't want that to be the case because that will never, never work in the long run. So I attract people using the word strategies, but then I try to teach the logic of the market. Okay? Buyers and sellers is your whole concept, really? Yeah, it's a whole understanding of what buyers and sellers are doing. Buyers and sellers are the big boys, and how humans who are not the big boys are reacting to that information. Yeah, exactly. It's the mindset behind it. London Open Breakout Webinar. Saeed, we haven't perfected open markets yet, so that maybe not yet. Naveen, do you usually retracements work slower and slower? Yes, always, always. Retracements will get slower and slower and slower and they die. Do you do a seminar on market profiling? A lot of the information that we teach comes from market profiling as well. There's a book from Chicago Mercantile Exchange. If you go to the CME website, there is a book from Market Profile. I recommend you read that. It's available for free. Okay. T, yes, it's recorded. All right, guys, so that's it for today. I will send out the recording to your emails probably in 24 or 48 hours. I will also put in the link for the Fast Track course, so those of you who haven't watched it can watch it. Okay? Thanks a lot, guys. Take care. Thank you for attending. Until next time. Bye for now. Cheers, guys.